any news medium, or shall I say any platform, in the past for 70 years. And I think we have to congratulate the Tribune for having
you appear on any consortium candidate in Lagos State. And I want to know, this is not the first time you're contesting. What are you going to get right this time?
Well, we got it right the last time. So it's not right to say we didn't get it right. Yes, we're not declared the winner. But let me say that this time around, I keep saying that we had a base last time, a very firm base. That base remains more or less intact.
Okay.
And since then, we've added more to that base. And so for us, it can only be better. We have every confidence that events played out in Lagos are to our advantage.
It's believed that at the last election, you said you won, but you were not declared winner. Now, the strategy that was used against you then, do you think the strategy has been demolished now?
Well, let me say that we have learned our lessons from the last time, and that this time round, we are ready.
How prepared are you personally?
Very prepared. More prepared than you can imagine.
You've been making so much. You've been having your way, particularly on social media. People love you. They see what you do. How does that translate to the physical vote on election day?
It's not only social media. Don't forget that even in the results that were declared in 2015, we had some nearly 700,000 votes. That was not social media votes. Those were votes on the ground. And I'm saying that this time around, it's even going to be more. I have every confidence that we're going to win. We're not even going to win by a very small margin. And mark my words, we're going to win fair and square. It was unacceptable. It's unrealistic. Where you have a land use charge that is, in fact, I mean, imagine a landlord who you are giving land use charge that is higher than the rent is going to collect. It doesn't make sense. It's out of touch with reality.
Is it part of the country?
Yes, it is. I mean, we talk about multiple taxes, we talk about levies. We say that must stop, we must streamline taxes and levies. You see, what is happening in Lagos is that it's working to the answer. You have a situation where government has decided it wants to collect 100 naira. Now, you have less than 50% of people who are paying 100 naira. And it says, well, since we want to collect 100 naira, then the few people that we have caught must pay that 100 naira. So we begin to load different levies, different taxes and all. Whereas, you should work harder in expanding that tax debt rather than overburdening those that are caught in trap.